एवरीवन, ए सर्क्यूट ब्रेकर इज ए प्रोटेक्टिव डिवाइस यूज फॉर इन द पावर सिस्टम फॉर आइसोलेटिंग द फॉल्टी पार्ट ऑफ द सिस्टम फ्रॉम द रेस्ट ऑफ द सिस्टम. इन ए सर्क्यूट ब्रेकर देर आर मेनली टू कॉन्टैक्ट्स, ए फिक्स्ड कॉन्टैक्ट एंड ए मूविंग कॉन्टैक्ट. ड्यूरिंग नॉर्मल ऑपरेटिंग कंडीशन द फिक्स्ड कॉन्टैक्ट इज इन touch with moving contact and it will give a current, continuous current flow. While fault occurs in the system, the moving contact is separated from the fixed contact by tripping action provided by the protective relay. When the moving contact is separated from the fixed contact, an arc is formed between the contacts due to the ionization of air between the contacts. So, the circuit breaker is said to be completely interrupted. The circuit is interrupted only if the arc is extinguished, because arc provides a conductive path for the current. And depending on the method of arc extinction, based on the insulating medium used, the circuit breakers are classified as oil circuit breakers, air blast circuit breakers, vacuum circuit breakers, and sulfur hexafluoride circuit breakers. The oil circuit breaker. In an oil circuit breaker, there is a chamber filled with oil, and the moving contact and fixed contacts are placed in the chamber. When the moving contact is separated from the fixed contact, the arc is formed between the contacts, or arc formed in the oil present in the tank. When the oil is heated up, the hydrogen gas is produced in the tank. The hydrogen gas has high heat conductivity and cools the arc. Thus, it aids the deionization of medium between the contacts and helps for arc extinction. And another factor which facilitates the arc extinction is the gas sets up a turbulent flow in the oil, and it forces it into the space between the contacts, and ionized particles between the contacts are swept away from the arc path. So, by using these two properties, the arc can be extinguished. We can see the oil circuit breaker in detail. The oil circuit breakers are mainly classified as bulk oil circuit breaker and low oil circuit breaker. In bulk oil circuit breakers, a large quantity of oil is used, and the oil serves mainly two purposes. It extinguishes the arc during opening of the contact, and also it is used as an insulating medium, or it insulates the current conducting parts from one another and from the earth tank. So, the quantity of oil used in bulk circuit breaker is large for insulation purpose and also for arc extinction. Mainly two types of bulk oil circuit breakers are there: plain break oil circuit breaker and arc control oil circuit breaker. First one is plain break oil circuit breaker. This figure shows a plain break oil circuit breaker. It consists of a port in that fixed and moving contacts are placed, and it is filled with oil up to a certain level. This is the oil level, and air cushion is provided above that level. When the moving contact is separated from the fixed contact, the arc is formed between the contacts, and the oil gets heated up, and hydrogen gas is formed in the tank. This hydrogen gases moves at the towards the top of the chamber, and this hydrogen gas will deionize the air, or it will absorb the heat and cools the arc, thus aiding the deionization of arc. And also, while hydrogen gas is formed, there is a turbulent flow of gas between the contacts, and ionized particles are moved away from the path of the current. So these two factors facilitates the arc extinction. It is plain brake coil circuit breaker. Here a air cushion is provided for accommodating the hydrogen gas. Here arc extinction is mainly done by increasing the length of the arc. While the moving contact is moved from the fixed contact, the length of the arc is increased. The main disadvantages of this plain brake coil circuit breaker is there is no special control over the arc other than increase in length by separating the moving contact. Therefore, for successful interruption, long arc length is necessary. So these breakers have long and inconsistent arcing time depending on the current, and it depends on the length of the arc. So the arcing time is inconsistent. These breakers do not permit high speed interruption. High speed interruption is not possible. So because of these disadvantages, it is used only for applications below 11 kV, up to 11 kV for low voltages. So instead of plain brake oil circuit breaker, arc control oil circuit breakers are used. In arc control oil circuit breaker, a rigid cylinder of insulating material is used and fixed and moving contacts are placed in the port. Moving contact is a cylindrical rod passing through the restricted opening at the bottom of the cylinder. Here the moving contact is moved from the port to outwards at the operation of circuit breaker. When the fault occurs, contacts get separated and arc is struck between them. The heat of the arc decomposes oil into hydrogen gases, and this is a closed port with completely filled with oil. So high pressure is produced inside the port. This high pressure forces this oil and gas through and round the arc to extinguish it. There will be a high turbulent motion of the gas and oil that will help to extinguish the arc. And even if the arc extinguishing doesn't take place inside the port, the moving contact will be moves outwards from the port. And when it is moved outward, the arc extinguishing occurs immediately. It is because emergence of moving contact from the port is followed by a violent rush of gases and oil through the throat, producing the rapid extinction of the arc. So the arc control can be increased by using arc control in oil circuit breakers. So the operating time of the arc extinction circuit breaker can be reduced in arc control oil circuit breaker. The next type of oil circuit breaker is low oil circuit breaker. It uses minimum amount of oil. In low oil circuit breaker, the oil is mainly used only for arc extinction. The insulation is provided by some other materials, by air or porcelain or organic insulating material. This figure shows a low oil circuit breaker. It consists of two chambers, an upper chamber and a supporting chamber. The moving contact and fixed contact are placed in the upper chamber, where the lower one is a supporting chamber, and two chambers are separated by a partition, and oil from one chamber is prevented from mixing with other chamber. The circuit breaker chamber requires a small volume of oil, just enough for arc extinction. The amount of oil to be replaced is reduced that the oil in the supporting chamber does not get contaminated by arc. The arc is mainly produced in the top chamber, so only small portion of the arc is to be replaced after the fault, after the operation of the circuit breaker. While moving contact is separated, oil to pass through the central hole in the moving contact and resulting in forcing series of oil through respective passage of the tabulator and the arc is quenched. When it is separated, the moving contact is a hollow cylinder and the oil is passed from the moving contact to the arc path and the arc is extinguished. The main advantages of oil circuit breaker are: it requires smaller space for installation, maintenance problems are reduced, and require less quantity of oil. And the risk of fire is also reduced in low oil circuit breaker. The main disadvantages are: the degree of carbonization is increased due to the less quantity of oil. And difficulty of removing the gases from contact space in time. And also there is possibility of explosion. The dielectric strength of the oil deteriorates rapidly due to the high degree of carbonization. So there is need of replacement of the oil. Next type of circuit breaker is air blast circuit breaker. In air blast circuit breaker, the figure shows an air blast circuit breaker. The compressed air between 20 to 30 kilogram per centimeter square is used for arc extinction. There is a compressor for maintaining the pressure of the air. The arc is blown away by the blast of air under pressure. After arc extinction, arcing chamber is again filled with compressed air to prevent restriking of the arc. The air gap is nearly 1.75 centimeter is very small between the contacts after separation. That is an advantage of air blast circuit breaker. With small length of the arc itself, the arc can be extinguished. There are mainly three types of air blast circuit breakers: axial blast, cross blast, and radial blast. In axial blast type circuit breaker, the air flow is along the path of the ionized particles or the arc. The fixed and moving contacts are held in the closed position by spring pressure under normal condition, and this spring is released during the faulty condition. And in cross blast, this type of breaker, air blast is directed at right angles to the ionized part, arc path. Cross blast lengthens and forces the arc into a suitable chute for arc extinction. Then radial blast has movement of axial and cross flow of air. The main advantages of air blast circuit breakers are: the risk of fire is eliminated as the medium is air, and it is cheap compared to the oil circuit breaker. Arcing time is very less, thereby less burning of contacts. And the disadvantages are: the air blast circuit breakers are very sensitive to variation in rate of rise of restriking voltage. We will be explaining the rate of rise of restriking voltage later. Maintenance required for compressor plant which supplies air blast. The air should be kept at high pressure by using a compressor. The maintenance is required for that compressor plant. The figure shows an axial blast circuit breaker. Its working can be explained in detail. Here there is an air reservoir, an arcing chamber, and fixed and moving conduct. Fixed and moving conduct are held in closed position during normal condition. And the air reservoir is connected to the arcing chamber through an air valve. When fault occurs, the tripping impulse causes opening of this air valve. The trip signal opens this air valve. The high pressure entering the arcing chamber pushes away the moving contact from against spring pressure. The moving contact is kept in position by the spring. And when the air valve is opened, the high pressure air moves this moving contact from the fixed contact. At the same time, this high pressure air flows along the arc and takes away the ionized gases from the arcing path. And hence the arc is extinguished and the current flow is interrupted. Next is a vacuum circuit breaker. In such circuit breaker, the vacuum is used as the insulating medium. Vacuum in the range of 106 to 107 torr is used. Since vacuum offers very high insulating strength, and it has far superior arc quenching property than any other medium. As soon as the arc is produced in vacuum, it is quickly extinguished due to the fast rate of recovery of dielectric strength in vacuum. So, this shows the figure of a vacuum circuit breaker. There is fixed and moving contact. When the moving contact is separated from the fixed contact in vacuum, the arc is extinguished immediately. Because the metallic vapors, electrons and ions produced during the arc are diffused in short time and seized by the surface of the moving and fixed members and shields. Since it is in vacuum, all the ionized particles are absorbed by this arc shield and the contacts. Since the vacuum has very fast rate of recovery of dielectric strength, arc extinction in vacuum breaker is with a short contact separation. So it requires only short contact separation. The moment of a moving contact, the length is required is very less. But the only problem is the cost of creating vacuum. And if the vacuum is lost, it may reduces the operating time of the circuit breaker. So main advantages are it is very compact, reliable and have longer life and have low arc energy and risk of fire can be eliminated. As in case of oil circuit breaker, there is risk of fire and maintenance is less and there is no generation of gas during and after operation. And also they can withstand lightning surges. The disadvantages are the vacuum circuit breakers are very expensive. The production in small quantities of vacuum is uneconomical. They require high technology for production, and in case of loss of vacuum, the entire breaker becomes useless. It is usually used in the range of 22 kV to 66 kV. Next is sulfur hexafluoride or SF6 circuit breaker. SF6 is an electronegative gas and has strong tendency to absorb free electrons. The contacts of the breaker are opened in high pressure flow of SF6 and arc is struck between them. The SF6 gas will absorb these arc ionized particles. The conducting free electrons in the arc are rapidly captured by the SF6 gas and it makes the ions to immobile negative ions. This loss of conducting electrons in the arc builds up enough insulation strength and it extinguishes the arc. So, electronegative property of SF6 gas is 100 times as effective as air in quenching the arc. So SF6 gas has excellent heat transfer property and then all common gases. This is the diagram of an SF6 circuit breaker. There is a SF6 chamber and moving contact and fixed contact with an arcing horn. So moving contact and fixed contact are in closed position during normal condition, and it is placed in an arc interruption chamber containing SF6 gas. The chamber is connected to the SF6 reservoir. When the contacts of the breaker are opened by valve mechanism, high pressure SF6 gas is flowed from the reservoir to the arcing chamber. The fixed contact is a hollow cylinder fitted with an arc horn. The moving contact is also a hollow cylinder. So the SF6 gas will flow through these contacts in the arc path, and this SF6 gas will absorb these ionized particles and extinguishes the arc completely from the path. The main advantages are, due to the arc quenching property of SF6, the operating time required is very less. And since the dielectric strength of SF6 is 2 to 3 times than that of the air, these breakers can interrupt large currents. The SF6 circuit breaker gives noiseless operation due to its closed gas circuit, and the risk of fire is eliminated because SF6 gas is non-flammable. And the main disadvantages are, it is costly due to the high cost of SF6. And sealing problems arise. Imperfect joints give rise to leakage of gases. So tight shielding is required. After every operation, SF6 gas has to be reconditioned so that additional equipment is required for reconditioning of the SF6. These are the disadvantages. So the main types of circuit breakers are oil circuit breaker, minimum oil and bulk oil circuit breaker, air blast circuit breakers, vacuum circuit breakers, and SF6 circuit breakers. Thank you.